moving on to topic physical property of tannins. Physical property of tannin, in which first property is they are astringent in taste. Means they have a astringent taste. So all the tannins have a astringent taste. Second, they have a tanning property. So we already studied what is a tanning property. Tannins have a tanning property, means they convert animal skin into the leather. So they are used in a leather industry. So second property, they have a tanning property. Solubility. Solubility, in which they are soluble in water, dilute alkali, alcohol, glycerol and acetone. So in this solvent, they are soluble. The solvents are water, dilute alkali, alcohol, glycerol and acetone. And sparingly soluble in other organic solvents. Aqueous solution of tannins are acidic. When we prepare the solution of tannin in water, the solution is acidic. So aqueous solution of tannins are acidic. Tannins are non-crystalline compound. They are non-crystalline compound. So this is all physical property of tannins, in which astringent taste, tanning property, solubility, smell. Then aqueous solution of tannin is acidic and they are non-crystalline compound. Now chemical property. So chemical property, as we are discussed, that tannins are organic compound, will contain carbon. Non-nitrogenous means doesn't contain nitrogen. But polyphenolic compound means they contain the phenols in their structures. So here I am giving some structures of tannins. First, we all are know the tannins are two type of hydrolyzable tannin and condensed tannin. So hydrolyzable tannin, in that examples are gallic acid and ellagic acid, where condensed tannin, the example is catechin, catechol. Okay, so first gallic acid, here you see that many OH groups are there on benzene ring, gallic acid. So it is a acid ester or acid of phenols. So acid, C-double-O, these are the phenolic compound. Okay, so gallic acid, glucogallin, means with on a gallic acid, removal of OH, and with the help of oxygen, the glycosidic linkage is formed, which is we already discussed in glycoside plus glucose. Glycon part, a glycon part and oxygen, which help to form glycosidic linkage. It is a glycogallin. Then ellagic acid. Ellagic acid is a form by condensation of two gallic acid. So here ellagic acid, here this is a OH, OH and OH and COOH. This is the one gallic acid, this is the another gallic acid. But twisting of one ring structure, because the OH, OH and OH, and this is a COOH carboxylic group, here this ring COH, and removal of hydrogen, okay, the ring are condensed and gives ellagic acid. So ellagic acid contain condensation of two gallic acid. If you remember the structure of gallic acid, then easy to remember the structure of ellagic acid. And you all are know OH, OH and phenolic compound, so polyphenolic compound. Now catechin, so it's also have a structure like catechol, but it is also polyphenolic. So benzene ring OH present, so this is a structure of catechin. Okay, benzene ring OH, OH, benzene ring OH, OH. This ring you have to remember, but which is a basic structure of catechol. So this is a structures of catechol, gallic acid, ellagic acid, by which we understand it doesn't contain nitrogen, it is a complex or organic compound and polyphenolic in nature. And by this structure we also remember its definition, that it is a complex organic compound, high molecular weight, then non-nitrogenous and polyphenolic in nature. Uses of tannins. Now in uses of tannin, the tannin, in which place it is used, and then denoting the uses of that tannin. So uses of tannins, first use, it is used as an astringent. Then they have a tanning property, means they convert skin into the leather. So they are used in leather preparations industry. They have a protective effect. So because of the protective, they have a protective effect in ulcer. So they are used in ulcer. Third use, they are used as an antiseptic. So they have an antiseptic effect, and because of that have an antiseptic effect, they are used in chronic ulcer, wound sealing, piles, stomatics, and in dental preparations. For example, myrobalan. So this drug is used as an antiseptic in these conditions. Now, fourth use is it is used as a septic, means they have a hemostatic property. Septic means they have a hemostatic property, so they check bleeding. It stop the bleeding. Example, tannic acid. Then used as a laxative. We all know amla, behda, and myrobalan. It is used as a laxative. Okay, their powders are used, and people are taking that powder when they have a GIT problems, they have a constipations. So they are used as a laxative. Used in dye ink preparations. So tannic with many chemicals, they produce different colors: orange, red, brown, yellow, blue. So they are used to produce many ink colors. So they are used in dyes and ink preparations industry. Now as an antidote, they are used as an antidote where because they give precipitations or they produce precipitate of heavy metals. So when we have a poisoning or we take large amount of heavy metals or alkaloid, so because of that we have a heavy metal poisoning or alkaloid poisoning. And during this poisoning, when we have the person suffering from heavy metal poisoning or alkaloid poisoning, at that time tannin is used as an antidote, because in presence of tannin, the heavy metals or alkaloids, they are precipitated out. Okay, and so it is used as an antidote. So these all are the uses of tannins, where tannins are used. Chemical taste of tannins. Now chemical taste of the tannin, in which we are discussing about the tannins which gives which taste positive. So tannins with epicl tree gives dark blue or greenish blue color. So with epicl tree we are easily identify whether the drug contain tannins or not. Then tannins in presence of gelatin and HCl gives precipitates. Tannins with ferric cyanide and in presence of ammonia, means alkaline environment, gives deep red color. Tannins with the salt of copper, lead, tin, they give precipitates. Tannins with the strong solution of potassium chromate or 1% chromic acid, it gives precipitates. Most important taste of tannin, gold bitter skin taste, which is a most important taste of the tannin, gold bitter skin taste. And you must remember this taste, gold bitter skin taste, in which we take gold bitter skin, animal skin, add HCl 2% solutions and wash with water. After that we add ferrous sulfate, 1% solution of ferrous sulfate. Then skin become brownish or blue in color. Okay, next taste is phenazone taste. Phenazone taste, in which drug in presence of sodium acid phosphate filter, take the filtrate, add phenazone solutions, it gives color precipitate. Then drug containing tannin, add vanillin hydrochloric reagent, means vanillin hydrochloric reagent, means vanillin which are solubilized in hydrochloric acid solution. So drug plus vanillin hydrochloric reagent gives red precipitate. Now last taste, which is a matchstick taste. Matchstick taste, which is the most important taste, as that of gold bitter skin taste. Gold bitter skin taste, all the tannins give positive. So by the gold bitter skin taste, we find whether tannin is present or not in a particular compound. Now matchstick taste, this is a taste only for catechin, catechol, condensed tannin. Condensed tannin only give matchstick taste positive. Now for the mastic test, we take the mastic, dip in the plant extract which contain tannins. Okay, so we take the mastic, dip into the solution of plant extract, then dip mastic into the concentrated solution of hydrochloric acid. So we dip the mastic in solution of concentrated HCl. So first we dip the mastic into the solution of plant extract, then dip this mastic into the hydrochloric concentrated hydrochloric acid solution, then warm near the flame, and wood of the mastic is converted into the pink, red or purple color. Why this color is produced on the mastic? Because the catechin present in a plant extract with HCl, they produce fluoroglucinol, and this fluoroglucinol in presence of HCl, concentrated HCl, the mastic is a wood pulp, contains xylem and xylem contain lignin. So fluoroglucinol plus concentrated HCl in presence of lignin, they give pink, red, purple color. As we already carried out this practical in our sections for lignin containing cells, to see the lignin containing cells, they are converted into pink color in presence of fluoroglucinol and HCl. Same test, but what happened here? In the mastic contains wood part, it contains xylem and xylem contains lignin. Now when mastic we dip in the solution of plant extract contains catechin. This catechin, okay, now mastic dip into the HCl, concentrated HCl. So catechin plus concentrated HCl, they both produce fluoroglucinol. This fluoroglucinol in presence of HCl, this HCl is also present. So fluoroglucinol and concentrated HCl plus lignin present in a mastic xylem, okay, mastic, so lignin. So fluoroglucinol, HCl and lignin produce pink, red, purple color. So mastic part become pink, red and purple color, and this is the taste of only condensed tannin which contain catechol. So this is a specific taste for the catechin. Now in all these taste of tannin with different chemical, they produce different color. As they produce different color like red, brown, blue, green, purple, then pink. So different color with the different chemical, tannin produce different color. So they are used in also in a dye industry to produce different color. So this is also a main use of tannin, because tannin, by this all the chemical test, we find that with the different chemical they produce different color, and because of this different color they are used in dye industry to produce different color. Now moving on to next topic, which is the isolation of tannin. Isolation of tannin, in which we are going to study about how we can isolate tannins from the crude material, from the plant material, whether any part of the plants are there. So isolation of pure tannin, which is a quite difficult method because it have a higher molecular weight, because we all know that tannins have a high molecular weight, and because of the high molecular weight its extraction is quite difficult. But solvent used for the isolation of tannins, they are ether alcohol, strong or dilute alcohol, acetic ether, water and methyl alcohol. These solvents are used to isolate or to extract out the tannin from the crude material or from the plant material. Now raw material means the crude material or the plant parts. Extract with ether alcohol, which is a solvent, and the ratio is 4:1. Now filter. After the filtration we get residue and filtrate. Discard the residue and take the filtrate. In the filtrate we add water. Okay, so in a separating funnel we take the filtrate which contain ether and alcohol solvent and water. Shake well and then collect the aqueous solution, means collect the water layer. Water layer contain all the tannins. Now further in separating funnel, take the aqueous solution and add ether and shake repeatedly. Okay, so shake repeatedly with the ether. So separating funnel contain water, and ether. Both layers are separated. Then we take the water layer and all the ether layer which we can separate out, they are discarded. So combined ether layer is discarded and aqueous layer means the water layer we take. Then take the water layer, evaporate up to the dryness, then we get at the end residue. This residue is tannin, but it is in a crude form, not a pure tannin. Okay, so what we are doing, we take this crude tannin or residue, add alcohol in that solution, and then after adding alcohol, add ether, and then remove. Or when we add alcohol, then add ether. After that, the precipitate is formed, which is a pure precipitate of tannin. So this is a whole method how we can isolate tannins from the crude material.